Another Sock Music.
To me, I feel that the Christmas party is a great opportunity for us to be able to connect with some of the people that we don't get to see on a daily basis.
I think to get together, to see each other, to kind of have a little reward every other year, it's nice.
You know, you can call somebody up and it seems like we know more on a personal level. The interactions are more genuine and people seem to care about each other more.
It's a way for the management and the owners to say thank you to the people for the hard work that they've done over the past couple of years.
They walk into that place and they think they're in desert paradise.
I feel refreshed when I come back and I feel like I can talk to people on a more personal level within the company, and it's a lot of fun.
That's what we try to do with the Christmas parties, find a place that's, wow, where'd you find this place, right? So. There was lots of trash talk going on with any of the activities we did, just because everybody likes to compete so much.
I'm expecting to get out of the room in under 60 minutes.
Right about here. Just above this guy.
We might escape. If not, we're going to have Nathan just run through the wall.
My expectations is 100% success in winning. We're going to beat
Preach.
Chris and Steve.
It's going to be a good time.
So the other team got out. There was an 85% success rate, so I'm glad they did. As opposed to our team, which was only a 15% success rate.
It was pretty disappointing for us to not get out of the bomb squad, especially when we were so close. We had the sequence and we just messed up the sequence at the end.
Well, my expectations going into the escape room were that whatever team I was on would get out in the time allowed. And we did.
We barely missed it and it was on me, so I got a little bit too quick with something that required perfect timing. So.
Knowing that my little brother Daniel was on Chris's team in the same room just before our team went in and they didn't make it, made it really, really like, we need to win. We have to escape you guys. Like, we have to prove that we can beat it when they didn't. So, and we did. We made it through with just 16 seconds left.
We escaped the inside job.
Go-karts were sweet. Go-kart, I had never been on go-karts that fast, so they were sweet.
We are having a little competition, and we are making the loser of the competition wear a shirt tomorrow to our Superior Games. It's just, you're losing all your pride, okay?
We're gonna look really good in these do-rags.
We already do.
We're here to race, and my good buddy Jade here plans on winning.
I know I won't lose.
I think it's all safe to say that we're going to beat management.
Champion of the 2018 Superior Go-Kart Circuit was none other than our own Joe Petro.
Put it on.
Look at that face.
Drum roll. The last person before the loser.
I love this company.
Is Lucas.
Well, first I was surprised that Steve didn't win because he's been known to pay off the people at Big Kahuna to make him go faster.
I knew going in that I wouldn't lose. And, you know, I mean, there's like a cameraman who was coming, so I knew I could beat him.
The thing I was probably most surprised about is how fast Joe went. You know, I thought he only ever really cared about trying to find clothes that fits, but he actually really cares a lot about racing.
Seeing my little brother have to put on the Hillary Clinton t-shirt, it was hilarious.
If you can't handle a loss, then don't put yourself in a position where you can win or lose. When I go into any competition, I'm like, if I lose, I'm gonna own it. And I think this was a little different because I got a t-shirt out of it. So you tell me who's the real loser. I feel like I won.
It really wasn't that big a deal for Dan to put on that t-shirt because he's been a supporter all along. You know, we've got a bunch of those people here that, I mean, it was hard for me because I love Trump and everybody else here loves Hillary. And, you know, something I've really had to pray about.
I was terrified from the moment that I woke up. And, like, I really don't like heights, and I think most people are aware of that.
Katie, afraid to get on an airplane for 4 out of the 5 Christmas parties, okay? Get on an airplane and then sign up for the zip line. And when she signed up for the zip line, I'm like, I just wanted to see her do it.
You got it. Oh my gosh, I can't.
I almost backed out, but then
5 and 6, zip away.
I just went. Once it was over, I was really excited. You gotta face your fears, right?
Even the people that wasn't that big a deal for the heights, that last zip line was a very good one.
There we go.
Shutterstock Music.
Four years ago, we sat down and we came up with a purpose for the company, which is building lives as strong as your steel, caring more about the people than about the bottom line.
Superior Steel has been a family. It's more than a team.
What makes us good, what makes us strong is the people that work here.
Working for a company that keeps those core values at the forefront is second to none.
Steel is strong. It's tough, it's a hard material. It's used as the foundation for a lot of things. And I think this company has been the foundation for a lot of lives.